Dear students, in your textbook, page number 17, you can see one activity. You can do this activity at your home. For that, you need two syringes. Both of them are having the same diameter and same area of cross-section. So here you can see the two syringes. They are connected using a wire or pipe, and both of them are filled with water. So if we apply a pressure on this piston X, what happens? The pressure inside this syringe increases, and this increased pressure is transmitted to all direction, and the piston Y will experience the same pressure. That's it. So the pressure exerted on the piston X and pressure experienced at the piston Y will be same. Suppose if we apply a force of 1 Newton on the piston X, what happens? The same amount of force will be experienced at the piston Y. That is, this piston will also experience 1 Newton of force in upward direction. So why both X and Y experience the same force? Because both of them are having the same diameter and same area of cross section, is it? So if we apply 1 Newton of force on X, then same amount of force will be experienced at the piston Y. So in your textbook, one question is given: press lightly on the end X, what do you observe? So on pressing at the end X, what happens? The Y rises up. So write the answer here. Bring the ends X and Y to the same level. Place a slotted weight of 1 Newton. 1 Newton means 100 gram weight at the end X. What happens at the end Y? So if we place 1 Newton of weight on the piston X, what happens? This piston will rises up, is it? So what you have to write here? Y rises. Place a weight of 1 Newton at the end Y as well. What do you observe now? So here we already kept 1 Newton weight, is it? Now you have to keep the same 1 Newton weight here also. Means you have to keep 1 Newton weight on the both pistons. So what do you observe now? Whether this piston rise or compress? Yes, this piston will not move upwards or downwards, because we kept 1 Newton weight on both the pistons, is it? So both the pistons are balanced. Therefore, this piston will not move. So what you have to write here? X and Y are balanced. After that, replace the syringe X with one having slightly smaller diameter, and repeat the activity. See, here you can see these pistons are compared with a balance. Here you can see two pans. If you keep 1 Newton of weight on this pan, what happens? This pan moves downwards and this pan moves upwards. And if you keep 1 Newton of weight on both the pans, what happens? This balance will become balanced, is it? So in the same way, here also you can see, on keeping 1 Newton on both the pistons, they are balanced. In the next step, you have to replace this syringe X with the syringe having smaller diameter. So here you can see the syringe X is replaced with the syringe having smaller diameter. Now here you can see the syringe having bigger diameter, is it? Suppose imagine that the diameter or the area of cross section of this piston is 100 times greater than that of this piston. Okay. the area of cross section is 100 times greater than that of this piston. Suppose if we apply a pressure on the piston X, the same amount of pressure will be experienced at the piston Y. If we apply a force of 1 Newton, whether this piston Y will experience the same force? In this case, if we apply 1 Newton of force, this Y will experience the same 1 Newton force. But what about here, whether it is same or not? Let us check, okay? See here. Are you able to balance with 1 Newton at Y? Before that, read this. Then replace the syringe X with one having slightly smaller diameter and repeat the activity. So here, we have to keep 1 Newton of weight on the syringe X as well as we have to keep 1 Newton of weight on the syringe Y. Whether they are balanced? In this case, on keeping weight on both the pistons, they become balanced, is it? But here, they will become balanced? No. See, look at here. Here is a pan. This is a bigger pan and this is a smaller pan. On keeping 1 Newton on this bigger pan, it will does not make any difference. But if we keep 1 Newton on this smaller pan, what happens? It will move downwards, is it? So here you can see both the pans are not balanced. So in order to make balance, what we have to do? We have to add some more weight to this bigger pan, is it? So if we add 100 Newton of weight on this pan, it will balance with the smaller pan. So in the same way, what we have to do? In order to balance both this X and Y, we have to add some more weight on this piston X. That is, since I have already told that the area of cross section of Y is 100 times greater than that of this piston, therefore we have to add 100 Newton of weight on this piston Y. That is, the force experienced at the piston Y is different from the force exerted on the piston X. If we apply a force of 1 Newton on this piston X, then 100 Newton of force will be experienced at the piston Y. So what may be the reason? Because it is due to the difference in area of cross section. So look at here the equation. Pressure P is equal to force divided by area. So on rearranging, we can write force is equal to pressure into area. So here you can see force is directly proportional to area of cross section. That is, whenever the area of cross section increases, what happens? The force also increases. So here the area of cross section is more, that's why it will experience more force. See here, one question is given. Now increase the weight at Y and find out the weight required to bring both the ends to the same level. More weight was required at Y to attain equilibrium. It is not due to the increased surface area of water at the end. So here we have to add. Here we have to add more weight because of the increased surface area of the piston Y. And this principle is applied in hydraulic jack.